Hello friends, in the last video, we had seen one of the most important hypothesis test, that is chi-square test for association in Minitab software with the help of a practical example. In this video, we are going to learn another two sample hypothesis test, that is two sample Poisson rate in Minitab software with the help of a practical example for easy understanding and better clarity. So let's begin. Two sample Poisson rate. Use two sample Poisson rate when your data is count per unit to determine whether the population rate of the occurrences for the two groups are different, and to calculate a range of values that is likely to include the difference between the population rates. For example, the analyst for the postal service wants to compare the number of customer visits at two post offices. The analyst counts the number of customers that enter the each post office for 40 business days. The analyst then performs a two sample Poisson rate test to determine whether the daily rate of customer visits is different between the two post offices. Hypothesis for two sample Poisson rate. For the two sample Poisson rate, the hypothesis are as follows. Null hypothesis: H0 colon lambda 1 minus lambda 2 is equal to D0. That is, the difference between the population rates of two samples, that is lambda 1 minus lambda 2, equals to the hypothesized difference D0. Alternative hypothesis. Select one of the following alternative hypothesis. H1 colon lambda 1 minus lambda 2 is not equal to D0. That is, the difference between the population rates of two samples, that is lambda 1 minus lambda 2, is not equal to the hypothesized difference D0, or H1 colon lambda 1 minus lambda 2 is greater than D0, that is the difference between the population rates of two samples, that is lambda 1 minus lambda 2, is greater than the hypothesized difference D0, or H1 colon lambda 1 minus lambda 2 is less than D0, that is the difference between the population rates of two samples, that is lambda 1 minus lambda 2, is less than the hypothesized difference D0. Data considerations for two sample Poisson rate. To ensure that your results are valid, consider the following guidelines when you collect the data, perform the analysis, and interpret your results. 1. The sample data should be selected randomly. In statistics, random samples are used to make generalizations or inferences about a population. If your data is not collected randomly, then your results may not represent the population. 2. The data must be counts per unit, such as the number of calls per hour to a call center or the number of defects per unit in a shipment. If your data classify each observation into one of the two categories, such as pass or fail, then use two proportion test. 3. Each observation should be independent of all other observations. For observations to be independent, the probability of a particular outcome does not depend on any previous outcome. For example, if you select two parts and record whether they are defective or not, the outcome of the second part should not be depend on the outcome of the first. If your observations are dependent, then your results may not be valid. And 4. Determine an appropriate sample size. Your sample size should be large enough so that the following are true. The estimates have enough precision. The confidence intervals are narrow enough to be useful. And you have adequate protection against type 1 and type 2 errors. To determine the appropriate sample size for your hypothesis test, go to Power and Sample Size for two sample Poisson rate. Example of two sample Poisson rate. The analyst for the postal service wants to compare the number of customer visits at two post offices. The analyst then counts the number of customers that enter each of the post office for 40 business days. The analyst performs two sample Poisson rate tests to determine whether the daily rate of the customer visits are different between the two post offices. The analyst then follows the steps for doing a hypothesis test in line with the general procedure. Conduct a 2-sample Poisson rate in Minitab. 1. Select Stat, Basic Statistics, and then 2-sample Poisson rate. 2. From the drop-down list, select Each sample is in its own column. 3. In sample 1, enter branch A. 4. In sample 2, enter branch B. 5. In options, the confidence level is 95%. The hypothesis difference is 0. The alternative hypothesis is difference is not equal to hypothesis difference. Test method as estimate the rate separately and length of observation is 1. As a default, keep them as it is and click OK. And 6. Click OK in the main dialog box to get the results. You will get the results of analysis in the session window. Interpretation of results. In these results, the estimate of the population rate of occurrence for the difference in customer visits for two post offices is -7.7. You can be 95% confident that the difference in the population rate is between approximately -14.7 and -0.7. The null hypothesis states that the difference in the daily rate of customer visits between the two post offices is 0 because the p-value of 0.031 is less than the significance level of 0.05, the analyst rejects the null hypothesis and concludes that the daily rate of the customer visits are different between the two post offices. The 95% confidence interval indicates that branch B is likely to have a higher rate of customer visits than branch A. This is all about 2-sample Poisson rate test with the help of a practical example. We will see the next type of hypothesis test with the help of a practical example in the next video. For references, I have taken some part of this very detailed content from Minitab. Now to end, please like this video if you have found it useful, add your valuable comments and share this video to your friends and colleagues to improve and refresh their knowledge. If you want to get updates of such a videos from my channel, please do not forget to subscribe it and click on the bell icon and select to get all notifications. And finally, thank you for watching.